It had been 2 years since the American Civil War had begun. The Union Army had just defeated the Confederate soldiers at the Battle of Gettysburg. After the Battle of Gettysburg, President Lincoln made his Gettysburg Address speech to honor the fallen soldiers.
Many months later.
87 years ago, our fathers brought forth upon this continent a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now, we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation, or any nation, so conceived and so dedicated, can long endure.
One eternity later.
We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they here gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
The Civil War continued on for another 2 years and finally ended when General Robert E. Lee surrendered.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
Six days after Lee surrendered, John Wilkes Booth assassinated President Lincoln, which killed him only hours later.